up, travelers? It's Eliz.
And Derek.
From Means to Travel, and we are standing here in Glenfinnan, Scotland, in the Scottish Highlands, right next to the Glenfinnan Viaduct, one of the most popular tourist attractions in Scotland, in the Highlands. So, for that reason, we wanted to take a little bit of time today to do a few tips on when you're visiting here, what you should be doing and thinking about. And the reason why this is such a popular tourist destination is twofold. Yep. One, the Jacobite Steam Train. So the Jacobite Steam Train is a kind of old-fashioned steam train that folks can ride from Fort William over to
Malwick.
We're still learning how to pronounce that one in Scotland. And as it passes by, it kind of spews out all of its cool-looking steam, and it just looks really epic as it goes around the corner of this viaduct. So there's a lot of folks who love to come and see it and take photos. Another thing is that that train was actually featured in the Harry Potter movies, and so...
Well, it wasn't that train. It was the viaduct, right? So the viaduct was featured in it, and the Hogwarts Express would go by. So if it looks familiar and you're a Harry Potter fan, that's probably why.
Yeah. And then on top of that, this area itself has a ton of Scottish history behind it. Derek's going to get into that super fast.
Yeah, super quick. So Glenfinnan specifically was the location where the Jacobite uprising began. So this is where the troops who supported Bonnie Prince Charlie in his claim to the throne of England came together and, you know, did their call to arms. As it, you know, fans of history would know, that didn't end well with the Battle of Culloden.
But there's still a lot of, like, pride behind
this
area.
A lot of pride in the area for Scottish people. And there's a monument here as well. So that's going to get into our tips for visiting the Glenfinnan Viaduct.
So let's start those.
So number one, parking. Very important. So there are two parking options. One of them is a small parking lot right here next to the entrance to the Glenfinnan Viaduct. That is a rather small place and I think is currently under construction where they're expanding it to allow a lot more parking.
It was closed today, but when we came here in August of 2018, it was open. So do your research, see if anything online says one way or the other.
Yep. But if that is not available, if that's not an option, there is a National Trust of Scotland parking lot right by the monument.
And the Visitor Center.
And Visitor Center. And you can go there. They have coffee. They have a coffee bar and everything like that. So pretty nice. And as we are, we're members of the National Trust of Scotland. It's free parking. So if you have that membership because you plan to be here for a while and do a bunch of outdoor stuff, that's a great place to park and it's free. So that's number one, parking.
Number two is to get here early. So
yes.
When we were here in August of 2018, there were also hundreds of other people here too. It is an extremely popular tourist destination. And if you're here during high season, especially, we got here at 9 a.m. for the 10:30 train passing. And we got the last spot in that small parking lot. And we were amongst tons and tons of other folks, Harry Potter fans, Jacobite fans, et cetera, et cetera. So budget that time to get here early. And it does take about a 10-minute hike uphill to get from the parking lot to the viewpoint as well. So put that timing into your schedule as well. So that way you don't think that you're just pulling up to the parking lot and then seeing everything, all the action happen. So that's definitely tip number two, is to make sure that you come here early so that way you get a good spot for viewing.
Yeah, and on top of that one is that especially if you're into photography and if you have a tripod and you want enough space to be able to set it up, you definitely want to get here early.
Yes.
Otherwise, you're going to be squeezed in with everybody else and you're not going to really have that opportunity. So definitely, definitely take that with some
caution. And the ground might be wet for your tripod too.
So that just
brings us to the next one.
So number three is appropriate footwear. So it gets muddy. This is a dirt trail, and you know, no matter when it is, we're here in August, we're here now in November, it is a muddy place. So definitely make sure you're wearing waterproof shoes and not your nice white sneakers.
Right.
Because those will not be white for long. All right, and that brings us into tip number four, which is know the schedule, because the Jacobite Steam Train does not run year-round. It actually only runs through a limited season. And right now, because of the pandemic, it only runs until today. This is the last day. So know that in advance, because you don't want to show up, spend all your time driving here just to have no steam train.
Yeah, so look that up as well and make sure that you're getting here in time for either the first or the second steam train of the day, or make sure that the steam train's even running during the window of time that you're visiting Scotland. And the final tip, the fifth tip, is as much as is appropriate, definitely talk to the people around you once you're here. Both times that we've been here, we've done that, and it's been really cool to hear where everybody came from, because there are people from all over the world that come here. Harry Potter fans, Jacobite fans,
Photographers generally,
photographers,
yeah.
and it's basically like a UN of
Different people.
nations that gather to see this train go by.
Right now, not so much because of the pandemic. Most people are just from Scotland right now because England's under lockdown. But you know, we did meet a very delightful man who actually was standing like right back there, right behind you guys. And he had set up and done his pictures and whatnot, and he was really nice. He lives in Edinburgh and he's from Italy, so it was pretty cool to talk to him and his experiences. He gave us a few tips actually on places to go and things to see, so it was pretty neat.
Yeah, you're all going to be sitting here waiting for the train together, so you might as well kind of understand who's with you.
And you might be here a while if you took our advice to get here early, so you know, there's no reason to just sit here kind of like.
Yeah. All right. Well, thanks everybody for watching. If you liked this video, definitely give it a thumbs up down below if you feel like it was going to be helpful for you when you come visit. And also, if you haven't already, press that red subscribe button below too so you don't miss any of our future travel videos to come.
One more thing, real quick, before she does her key sign off. If you have any other locations within the Highlands that we should be checking out and maybe doing a video like this for, please leave that in the comments below. If there's anything that you've always wanted to see, please let us know.
Thanks everybody for watching and cheers. Happy travels. Bye.
Bye.
Hey travelers, don't forget to subscribe and let's hang out more. Here are some links to other helpful travel videos on my channel and press that notification bell so you don't miss any new and awesome travel videos to come.